friends. Today we are going to discuss methods by which we can convert a decimal number to its binary equivalent. So let's get started. Let us first look at a very quick and easy method by which we can convert a decimal number to its binary equivalent. Say we want to find the binary equivalent of the decimal number 1099. To do so, we will first identify the highest power of 2 which is less than 1099. As shown, the highest power of 2 which is less than 1099 is 1024. So we split 1099 as 1024 plus 75. Next, we find the highest power of 2 which is less than 75, which in this case is 64. So we again split 75 as 64 plus 11. Using the similar approach, we next find the highest power of 2 which is less than 11. We see that's 8. So 11 is split next as 8 plus 3. Finally, we again split 3 into a 2 plus 1 where both 2 and 1 happen to be powers of 2. After this, we list the positional widths of the binary numbers, that is, the powers of 2 from right to left. It is given in red in the figure. Now, taking a look back to the expression, we find that we have 1024, we have 164, 18, 12, and 11. So thus, we put a bit 1 against the positional weights 1024, 64, 8, 2 and 1. Rest of the positions are then filled in with 0. And ta-da! The resulting number is the binary equivalent of the decimal number 1099. Now coming to the traditional method, which is another way to find the binary equivalent of a decimal number. However, this method is a longhand and tedious method to follow in case of larger numbers. But anyway, let's check it out. Say we want to find the binary equivalent of the number. We start dividing the number 45 by 2. On dividing 45 by 2, we get 22 as the quotient and 1 as the remainder. The remainder is listed in the side in red. Again, we divide the quotient, that is 22, by 2. We will get 11 as the quotient and 0 as the remainder. Next, 11 is divided by 2 to give 5 as the quotient and 1 as the remainder. 5 further divided by 2 leaves 2 as quotient and 1 as the remainder. Next, we divide it by 2, 2 leaves 1 as quotient and 0 as the remainder. Finally, when we divide 1 by 2, we get 1 as the remainder as the quotient becomes 0. Now, considering the list of the remainders from in a bottom-up fashion, we get the binary equivalent of 45. That is 101101. Now let's take a look at another example, say 37. To get the binary equivalent of 37, we again continue dividing it by 2 while listing the remainder on the side as shown in red. Next, we read the remainders in a bottom-up fashion, which provides us with the binary equivalent of 37, that is 100101. Now let's see how we can convert a fractional decimal number to their binary equivalent. If a decimal number have a fractional part, that is something after the decimal point, the integral part, that is the part before the decimal point, is treated in the exact same way that we discussed earlier in our slides. Now, for the part after the decimal point, we start only at the fractional part with the integral part set to 0. Thus, for 12.36, the number 12 is converted to its binary equivalent using any of the methods we have just discussed earlier, and the fractional part is considered to be 0.36 initially. At every step of the conversion to its binary equivalent, we multiply the number by 2 and list the integral value of the number. So when 0.36 is multiplied by 2, we get 0.72. The integral part of 0.72 is 0. Thus, 0 is listed on the right, in red. Next, 0.72 is multiplied by 2 and we get 1.44. Here, the integral value is 1. So 1 is listed, then the integral part is ignored, and considering the fractional part again, which is 0.44, we multiply it by 2. We get 0.88, which again has a 0 in its integral part. 0.88 is further multiplied by 2 and we get 1.76. Since 1 is the integral value now, it gets listed. The process continues up to a fixed number of positions after the decimal point, just like we have learned in our mathematics classes, or it may end up in 0 value after the decimal point. Similarly, the process has been discussed for another number, 10.25. 10 here is converted to its binary equivalent using any of the methods we have discussed earlier. For the fractional part, 0.25 is initially multiplied by 2. We get 0.5 as the answer. Since the integral part of 0.5 is 0, 0 gets listed. Next, we multiply 0.5 by 2 and we get 1.0. Since the integral part is 1, it gets listed. And as we have nothing in the fractional part, we stop here. In order to get the binary value after the decimal point, we read the listing in a top-down fashion. Thus, the binary equivalent of 12.36 base 10 is 1100.0101, considering up to 4 decimal places, and the binary equivalent of 10.25 is 1010.01. That's it, friends. You have learned how to convert a decimal number to its binary equivalent. To learn how to find the decimal equivalent of a binary number, please click the link on the top right corner of the screen or check out the description box. Finally, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Thank you.